I wish, so when I first started, I wish I had realized that people were the most important thing to me. Because there was a time, you know, I'm such a hard worker, and when your passion is what you do for a living, it's very hard to not become a workaholic. And there was a time when I just almost lost sight of everything that was most important to me because I was working so hard and I was pushing so hard for these dreams and these goals and everything I wanted in life, and my life started to look very gray and colorless, and I realized I had lost a lot of depth because I wasn't making time for those most important things, which are my family, you know, the people in my life, or someone that maybe needed me at a time, but I was too busy to even notice. And those are the things that you can't fulfill your full passion, whether it's through music or art or dance, if you've lost sight of the things that make you a real person. And I had to like refine myself almost, like, wow, what is it that makes me me? And once I refound that, it's like everything else came together again. I was able to write again. I was able to create. But without those things, then you lose sight of everything. I wish I had better understood balance. And it's still a battle. Oh my gosh, every day trying to balance that. But at least I'm aware of what I want and where I need to be and always coming back to that. Oh man, Lindsey Stirling is, I guess, a quirky person, a little bit random, but I'm very hardworking and I care about people. I've learned that no matter what you fill your life with, no matter if it's success or music or this or that, ultimately it's people that make my life rich and full. I was doing classical music. I was performing in that way, and finally, I realized I wanted to make it fun, not only for me, but I wanted the audience to smile. I wanted to kind of catch people off guard, and so I started dancing. And it originally started out with just like a lean this way or an occasional foot stomp on that downbeat. Don't forget it, you know. And I've worked and worked and worked at my dancing and, you know, incorporating that while playing. And it went from being very awkward and probably looking very awkward to now it's just a part of my expression, and I almost can't stand still when I play. So it's fun. You know, the first, I think my big break when things just flipped for me was it was a YouTube video I released, and I had worked on this new style of music called dubstep. Everybody knows what dubstep is now, but when I was working on the song, it was kind of an emerging form of music. And I remember I worked so hard on that song. It was the longest I've ever taken to write a song, and I almost canned the project several times. And then I shot this video in this beautiful ice castle place in Colorado, and I, you know, flew out to Colorado to film it and everything. And when it was all said and done, I was absolutely terrified to release it because I was like, ooh, what if the dubstep community just really hates this song? What if it's not true dubstep to them? Or, you know, or what if, I don't know, it was a new style of music. It was kind of a risk, but and it was a song called Crystallize. And I just remember being so nervous, but you know what? I like the song. So I'm gonna release it. And so I released it, and within a day it had 1 million views. And it was the biggest, you know, the it was the that was by far the most I'd ever gotten in a day up to that point. And you know, the song went to the top, you know, 100 on iTunes and number one on the electronic charts. And I just remember thinking, and as this was happening, I was so shocked, and I thought, wow, I think things have just changed for me. Like I think this is gonna be my life. And, you know, before that, I was, you know, barely making it by being my little YouTuber self, but it just clicked then that this was something that was gonna last and it was a bigger picture. And it was just really exciting. And I learned from that you can't be afraid of what everybody else is gonna think, because I've also had projects that I was nervous about that weren't as successful. But, you know, if there's no risk involved, those are the things that make you stretch, and those are things that make you grow. And when they work, I guess they work really well in my case. I have very like I said, I have very eclectic tastes. So everything from, you know, Michael Jackson to, you know, classical composers inspire me. And I just love listening. Like, my playlists on my iPod are ridiculously all over the place. And I think that, as far as one person, that's kind of my inspiration. I would say Vanessa Mae was a huge influence on me, because when I first saw her music videos, you know, we have very different style, but she was the first person that I really saw who took the violin and did something really creative with it. You know, she was playing to techno music, and she was wearing really beautiful outfits and, you know, a little bit edgy. And I was just like, whoa, the violin can be fun. It can be whatever you want it to be. And I decided I would kind of take that example and, well, what do I want to be? How do, like, instead of letting the violin define me, how can I define the violin? And that was kind of Vanessa Mae that opened my mind up to that. Honestly, I think as of recently, electronic style artists like Skrillex had a huge impact on me. He was the first artist that I listened to dubstep music through. He kind of brought it mainstream. Going back to my childhood, though, classical music. I think the music from Borodin, he was a classical composer, and my dad had a record that he would play, and me and my sisters would always dance like crazy when Borodin's music came on for some reason. And then kind of in the middle there, I love Evanescence. They were my favorite band in high school, and to this day, probably my favorite band. And so I think that's where I get a little bit of the more rock side of my music from. But yeah, very diverse. You know, my album is basically kind of a combination of all of my favorite things musically. You know, I love electronica style music. I love, you know, everything in it. Dubstep. I love the violin and classical elements, and I love Celtic music. So I kind of just took everything, all my favorite styles of music, and decided to throw them all together. And this is kind of what happened. Ooh. Oh, man, live performing is just one of the most energetic experiences I've ever had. And, you know, I love being able to see the faces of some of the people, you know, in the front of the audience, and see them smile and to see them having fun. And especially I love that at my concerts, it's the most diverse crowd you've ever seen. We have little tiny girls that are dressed up like me, and they're holding their violin cases. And then, you know, we've got the metal kids off to the side that are just headbanging the whole show. And then, like, an older couple that just has always loved the violin. And so I love that diversity. And just the fact that at my concerts, everyone's welcome. Everybody can fit in, and, you know, like, a whole family can come, and all of them are enjoying it. And so to me, I love that it creates a community out of people that would probably never be in the same room together except at my show. And I love that. And it just feeds me a lot of energy as an artist. And to take away from the show, in my concerts, I love to almost, well, I hope to share with people some of my experiences, and I'll tell stories of, like, overcoming obstacles. And I just want to inspire everybody that they can achieve their dreams. And if you work hard, hey, I was told I wasn't good enough and I'd never make it. You know, don't ever let anybody tell you that, because you all have passions, you all have dreams, and you can achieve them. And so that's what I hope people can take away from the show, because honestly, most of my fans found me themselves. And so they feel a connection that I found her online. Like, I wasn't told to listen to her by the radio or any new media or, you know, whatever. It was, they, you know, they saw me rise, and they were with me as I did it. So I hope it inspires them that they can do the same thing. Oh my goodness. I feel like sometimes I could be the poster child of social media, you know, for a musician, because it's been everything to me. And I mean, I went on so many different, you know, ventures to try to get my music heard, whether it was sending it to record labels, going door to door to agencies in Vegas and LA, and just being turned away time after time. And, you know, I got so sick of being told that I wasn't good enough or that I wasn't ready. And social media is a platform where you decide, as an artist what you want to do. You decide when you're ready and how you're going to do it and what style. I mean, you are the artist, the ultimate artist. And I absolutely love that through that I was able to just do things the way I wanted to do it, and I was doing it for fun. I wasn't doing it to try to be famous or anything like that, and it just clicked. And I think that that authenticity is something you can't fake. And I think that's why people gravitate to artists through YouTube, is because you're doing what you absolutely love. And so social media has been key. It's been everything to my music career. Anybody can do it. If I could do it, you know, I love to share with teenagers and youth. I love to do motivational speaking and just share my experiences of failure. And then about how if you wade through those experiences and if you keep trying and you keep working hard and chasing your passions and your dreams, that, you know, it can happen for you. And the fact that, you know, I mean, I love those failure experiences. Now, they were terrible at the time, but they've made me into a deeper person, and I love to share those very tangible experiences that, you know, with youth, to show that, yeah, you know, you have to go through that, but there's more out there. The greatest moment of your life is always ahead of you. You never blew it. The failures you go through are the most important part of the journey. You know, that's what kind of makes or breaks you, and you decide, do I have what it takes? You know, am I strong enough? Because if you can't make it through the failures, you're not going to be ready for the successes.
You wouldn't appreciate it.
And you wouldn't appreciate it. You know, staying true to yourself, I think it's essential to stay true to yourself as an artist, because, one, you have to work so hard to get your work out there and to be an artist. And so if you don't fully love what you're doing, you'll go crazy. You'll burn out. And there's no way to work that hard if you're not being authentic to yourself, I feel. But also just, you know, like I said before, you can't fake authenticity. You can't fake passion. And I know that that's why a lot of people have told me they enjoy my music, is because they say, when you're up there on stage, you know, you can tell that I'm loving what I'm doing. And I think that's freeing to people. So many times we give liberties to other people, and, oh, that's so great that they are unique and that person is comfortable being themselves. But we don't always give the liberty to ourselves to step outside the box and to be ourselves fully. And there was a time when I walked other lines thinking, oh, I need to conform a little bit, and I wasn't as happy. And so I think that's just the most important thing, is that authenticity is something that is real and true, and that's when you can connect.